أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله الصلاة حي على
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا وسيئات اعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. الحمد لله غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي القول لا اله الا هو واليه المصير. الحمد لله الذي لم يتخذ ولدا ولم يكن له شريك في الملك ولم يكن له ولي من الذل وكبره تكبيرا. My dear brothers and sisters, my dearest children, I began by praising Allah Azza wa Jalla, the one whom we praise, and the one whom we ask for help and forgiveness. And I seek refuge by Allah from the evil of myself and the evil of my deeds. Whomsoever Allah guides, none will be able to misguide. And whomsoever Allah allowed to be misguided, none would be able to guide. And I praise Allah Azza wa Jalla, the forgiver of the sins, the acceptor of the repentance, the severe of punishment. Nothing is comparable to Him to whom we shall all return. وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ الْأَحَدُ الصَّمَدُ لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ بَلَّغَ الرِّسَالَةَ وَأَدَّى الْأَمَانَةَ تَرَكَّنَا عَلَى الْمَحَجَّةِ الْبَيْضَاءِ لَيْلُهَا كَنَهَارِهَا لَا يَزِيغُ عَنْهَا إِلَّا هَالِكٌ. I am bear witness that there is no God worthy of worshipping except Allah, the One, the Sufficient Master. He begots not, nor He was begotten, and there is not co-equal nor to ensure that what we have today in our hands is the last and the final message from Allah. عباد الله أوصيكم ونفس مبصرة بتقوى الله وأحذر به لزوما لقوله الحق تبارك وتعالى في كتابه الكريم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وكذلك في قول الحق تبارك وتعالى يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. اتقوا الله فإن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. I began by encouraging you and myself first of all to fulfill the commands of Allah, disobeying Him, according to Him telling us in the Quran, O you who believe, fear Allah the way He should be feared, and by not accepting the state of Islam. And for Him also telling us in the Quran, O mankind, fear your Lord, the one who created you from one soul, and created its mate from it, and created from them so many men and women. And fear your Lord, by whose name you demand your mutual rights from one another. And fear your Lord, by observing the right of your blood-tied relatives, your Rahim. Fear your Lord, as the shaking of the hour is so horrible, When you see the pregnant dropping her load and the nursing mother too busy to look after her baby. And you see people walking in the street with drunken, and they're not drunken. It's the punishment of Allah Azza wa Jal that is so severe in that day. My dear brothers and sisters, we're still living in the spirit of Eid. And I would like to extend my Eid greeting to those whom I have missed on the first day and say, تَقَبَّلَ اللَّهُ طَاعَتَكُمْ وَغَفَرَ اللَّهُ لَنَا وَلَكُمْ. May Allah accept from you whatever you have called worthy during the month of Ramadan. And may Allah forgive our sins and accept us among His ibad al-salihin. Allahumma ameen. As we're speaking and as we're trying to enjoy and celebrate and show the happiness of the Eid, because it is a sunnah from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to express the happiness. وَلِتُكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةِ وَلِتُكَبِّرُوا اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ وَلَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. And as we're trying to fulfill the ayat of Allah Azza wa Jal, in which He said that to complete the number of days of the month of Ramadan and to glorify your Lord, so that you may thank Him for giving you the chance to be able to witness the month of Ramadan and to gain the barakat, the rahmat, and the forgiveness from Him. As we're trying to do that, the same is not unfortunately similar to other Muslims in the world. Speaking mainly about the people of Gaza, who are, as we're speaking right now in one of the houses of Allah Azza wa Jal, and as we have the luxury of being able to make it to the house of Allah for Salat al-Jum'ah, they are not the same. As we're speaking right now, they're trying under the shells and under the rockets, trying to look for the deceased, for the shuhada who had risen during this aggressive war and an unjust war against Palestinians. They're trying to look for those shuhada whose bodies have decomposed. And to those of you who have seen and watched the news this morning, you could not help it but wonder, what is the whole world? What is the whole world from what is happening to us, to a powerless group of people who belongs to the international community or a human being just like everyone else? They have feelings, they have children, they have family members, and they also grieve, and they interact, and they have rights upon those who are around them on this earth. Today, I would like to send my grieving feelings to the people of Gaza and say to them, may Allah accept your shuhada. May Allah accept them among His ibad al-salihin and give them al-jannah to Allahumma ameen. And may Allah the Mighty be with you, people of Gaza. Because you have demonstrated to the whole world that you are people who are stemming their power from the mighty Allah Azza wa Jalla. Despite of the killing, despite of the siege, despite of the collaboration of the whole world against you, you're still standing up and firm and saying, we are people of right and we're standing for our right. May Allah give you patience. May Allah give you sabr. And may the rahmat of Allah be coming down on you. Allahumma ameen. Today, I would like to start after sending the rahmat of the shuhada and the grieving and the condolences to the people of Gaza. I would like to start by sending a message. And this is an unusual Jumu'ah khutbah because we are living in unusual circumstances. I would like to start first by sending a message to Mr. Obama, to the person whom the whole world in 2009 were excited and demonstrating in the streets out of joy and happiness, that for the first time in the history of the United States of America, We are seeing a black person, an African origin person, going to the White House. Everybody was excited that justice had revealed that eventually the hard work of all the years have resulted in having someone like him in the White House, in the leadership of the United States of America. And today, we're saying to Mr. Obama, your name, after has been shouted out of joy and happiness in 2009, now in almost every corner in the world, you are being cursed and condemned. Shame on you! Shame on you, Mr. Obama. After we were proud of you, now we're denouncing you. And we're saying to you, stand up for your values, man. Stand up for the rights of those who were happy for you to be sworn into the White House. Do not be coward. Be like the people of Gaza, who do not look for immediate gratification, who look to be people who have stand up for their rights and for the values of humanity. We say to you, we don't care about the politics. We don't care about the excuses, whatever excuses that might be, that you will be giving to the whole world who are watching on the TV screens, who are watching on the internet. The children of Gaza who are being killed and their bodies are being decomposed because no one's there to be able to take them and bury them. We say to you, stand up for your rights. Stand up for the rights you have believed in, and do not let the joy of the whole world change to a curse on you, and do not let the history, after have written your name on the books of joy and happiness, to be denounced in the history of humanity. And another message I would like to send my fellow Americans, stand up for your rights. Stand up for the American values, because the American values are no different from the values of the Muslim Ummah. And because we are all sharing one common ground, that we're a human being, we deserve to live in integrity, and to deserve to live in honor. And this is what the Constitution and the values of the forefathers of the American nation call for. Stand up for your rights, man. Stand up for the humanity. And do not let a small minority of people to hijack the American dreams, to hijack the American values. We're talking to the average American who's struggling to find the end meat for his family. We're talking about the average American who's struggling to be able to have a health coverage for his own family members. Those are the people whom we share feelings together. Those are the people who feel our pains and who feel their pains. We're talking to them and to those free people all over the world. Stand up, it's time now to return things back to the normal position. We don't want small minority. We don't want the lobby groups to hijack the agenda of those two people who have struggled. How many people get killed during civil wars, whether in the US or in Canada, to nourish and cherish the human values that we all look forward to enjoy in our life. We say to the American people, do not let someone else hijack your agenda. Do not let someone else directly drag you to be from those who will be denounced in the history of the human mankind. Because what happened to Ad and Thamud, and what happened to the soldiers of Fir'aun, could happen once again in the 21st century. And we send a similar message to the Canadian people who have values and who have demonstrated their values in the different demonstrations in all the downtowns of the Canadian cities. Stand up and continue to stand up, because we're together standing for the right of the human rights of everyone on earth. We don't want any lobby groups to hijack and to kidnap our Canadian values. We are Canadian, and we believe in the Canadian values, which do not differ from the values of Islam. So we call upon every Canadian to stand up and to continue to demonstrate and to continue to denounce
and hijack into our Canadian values. And we say to our politicians, all of them, no exception of all the parties, do not be from those who history will be condemning. Do not be from those who will be cursed by everyone who have elected you on the offices in the parliament hell. Why on earth are Canadian representatives and MPs would be going to Israel to soothe the wounds of the soldiers who were not holding and carrying roses to the people, to the children of Gaza, but rather were carrying and using the most sophisticated and lethal war machine on earth to kill the children of Gaza? Why you are saying we're not going to Gaza, we will be only standing by the soldiers of Israel? Speak for yourselves. Do not speak about Canadians. Because every Canadian person who has values disagrees with you and denounces what you are doing. So we say to all politicians, be clear. Do not look for immediate gratifications. Do not only look for a position in the parliament hill, but rather look for your own values. Whether you're a man or a woman, look for something that would make you recognized and remembered in your life and after your death. Nelson Mandela have demonstrated to the whole world of a person who stands up for his right. Despite of his faith background, he's a man who believed in values, and history have given him the honor during his life and after his death. This is my message to my fellow Canadians and to my fellow Americans. We are together. We are together because we are people who believe in rights and values. And we don't want any lobby groups to separate us. We don't want the media, which I am ashamed of. I used to be of our Canadian media, the Canadian national broadcast, which I used to all the time speak in a positive way. I am ashamed of you. Speak, stand up for your values as people who try to portray truth. Be people of truth and honor, and do not be from those who look for immediate gratification, and do not be from those who follow the traps of the lobby groups. We are Canadians, and we stand for the rights of everyone else in the world. May Allah Azza wa Jal guide us to the truth. اللهم آمين وأقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه فيا فوز المستغفرين. الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. If you can come forward a little bit and fill the gaps next to you or in front of you, you help us get more people coming. Especially those fathers on the stage, inshallah, fill the gaps in front of you. My last and final message is to the whole Ummah. My message is to the whole Muslim Ummah. To the whole Muslim Ummah, define where you stand. Define where you stand right now, because history would not wait for you. Are you going to be from those whom Allah Azza wa Jalla spoke about in the Quran? When Allah said to us in the beautiful chapter in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اذكروا نعمة الله عليكم إذ جاءتكم جنود إذ جاءتكم جنود فأرسلنا عليهم ريحا وجنودا لم تروها وكان الله بما تعملون بصيرا. Allah is saying to us and repeating the message over and over again, يا أيها الذين آمنوا, all you who believe, remember when the confederates come on you to attack you in Medina, and when we send on them the wind and junudan, so the malaika, لم تروها, you did not see it, and Allah Azza wa Jal كان بما تعملون بصيرا, was watching you and see how you're going to react. Are you going to be saying, I do not care, or I am standing for my own values as a Muslim person, as a mu'min who believes that al-mu'min al-mu'min kal-bunyan al-marsus, Are we going to be standing up for each other? Are we going to feel our pains? Are we going to be feeling our joys? Or are we going to be letting every single person on earth be let down? And then eventually we will be next to them. We want to be from those who stand for Allah Azza wa Jal. إِذْ يَقُولُ الْمُنَافِقُونَ وَالَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ مَا وَعَدَنَا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ إِلَّا غُرُورًا. When Allah described the conditions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa the Sahaba, إِذْ جَاءُوكُمْ مِنْ فَوْقِكُمْ وَمِنْ أَسْفَلَ مِنْكُمْ وَإِذْ زَاغَتِ الْأَبْصَارُ وَبَلَغَتِ الْقُلُوبُ الْحَنَاجِرُ وَتَظُنُّونَ بِاللَّهِ الظُّنُونَا. Describing the conditions of the people of Gaza nowadays, when they were bombarded by the air, by the sea, by the land, and when their hearts reached their throats, and when their eyes were wandering around. وَتَظُنُّونَ بِاللَّهِ الظُّنُونَ هُنَالِكَ ابْتُلِيَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَزُلْزِلُوا زِلْزَالًا شَدِيدًا. At that moment, Muslims, Mu'mins were tested severely. Wallahi, my brothers and sisters, it's not the people of Gaza who are being tested. It is us who are being tested. We are being tested as we're living in the luxury and comfort of our house. As we're living in the comfort and luxury of our houses, we are being tested. Not them. Wallahi, lucky to them. Wallahi, they are lucky. Wallahi, they are going as shuhada, inshallah. It is us who are have failed to show our sympathy, to show our support and solidarity to them. We are being tested. إِذْ يَقُولُ الْمُنَافِقُونَ وَالَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ مَا وَعَدَنَا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ إِلَّا غُرُورًا. When the hypocrites said, what did Allah and our Prophet promised us? Is this what we're being promised with? The Confederate is collaborating on us? Is this what the whole world, is this what Allah Azza wa Jal is promising us? The whole world is, we're not talking about Israel, by the way. I'm not going to be defending or clarifying that the biggest terrorist on earth is Israel government. The apartheid that occupies the land of Palestine. This is a fact that is known to the children in almost every corner in the world. What I'm sending a message to right now is, where are the whole world? Where are the superpowers? Where are the Muslim leaders? Where are they? We don't need one of the most prominent leaders of the Muslim Ummah finally, after 3 weeks of killing for Muslims in Gaza, to send a voice message. We don't need your message. We don't need you. The whole world doesn't need them, but the children of Gaza don't want you to send a voice message to them. They want you to stand up for your right as a Muslim. They want you to stand up so that the history will be honoring you. We don't need your money to rebuild. Wallahi, the whole money on earth would not be justifying one drop from a blood that's coming from a child in Gaza. وَمَا وَعَدَنَا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ إِلَّا غُرُورًا. This is what we're seeing right now. We're seeing people saying who are doubting. We are seeing people who are doubting because they are hypocrites. Whether they are the government of the biggest nation of the Muslim Ummah, which is in borders with Gaza, who have closed the borders. We're not talking about the people in the Muslim Ummah. The people in the Muslim Ummah all are boiling. Every Muslim person on earth is crying because they feel powerless, helpless to stand up for their brothers and sisters in Gaza. We're talking about the regimes. We're talking about the governments whom Allah will be asking them in the Day of Judgment, what have you done? يَقُولُونَ حَلَّلَا مِنَ الْأَمْرِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ قُلْ إِنَّ الْأَمْرَ كُلُّهُ لِلَّهِ. يَقُولُونَ لَوْ كَانَ لَنَا مِنَ الْأَمْرِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ مَا قُتِلْنَا. قُلْ لَوْ كُنْتُمْ فِي بُيُوتِكُمْ لَبَرَزَ الَّذِينَ كُتِبَ عَلَيْهِمُ الْقَتْلُ إِلَى مَضَاجِعِهِمْ وَلْيَبْتَلِيَ اللَّهُ مَا فِي صُدُورِكُمْ وَلْيُمَحِّصَ مَا فِي قُلُوبِكُمْ. Wallahi, if Allah, as it happened in the Battle of Uhud, when they were saying, do we have a choice? Why are we being killed? Allah is saying to them, if you were to be in the comfort and the security of your own house and your own bed, and the time of death come to you, you will die. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تكونوا كالذين كفروا وقالوا لإخوانهم إذا ضربوا في الأرض أو كانوا غزا لو كانوا عندنا ما ماتوا وما قتلوا ليجعل الله ذلك حسرة في قلوبهم. Those who are standing and saying the Palestinian resistance have killed civilians, shame on you. Shame on you because you're repeating the same words of the hypocrites and the kuffar in the time of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ليجعل الله ذلك حسرة في قلوبهم. ولئن متم ولئن قتلتم او متم لفبي رحمة فبما رحمة من الله ولئن قتلتم او متم لا الى الله ترجعون.
We will be going back to Allah Azza wa Jal, whether you are being killed or being or you're dying or you're killed in the path of Allah Azza wa Jal.
And Allah Azza wa Jal has given us what the mu'mineen have said in the Quran. وَلَمَّا رَأَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الْأَحْزَابَ رَأَى الْأَحْزَابَ قَالُوا هَذَا وَعَدَنَا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَصَدَقَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَمَا زَادَهُمْ إِلَّا إِيمَانًا وَتَسْلِيمًا.
When the mu'mineen saw the confederators, they said, Allahu Akbar, هَذَا مَا وَعَدَنَا اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ. This is what Allah and His Prophet had promised us.
وَصَدَقَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ.
And both Allah and His Prophet have said the truth.
وَمِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ رِجَالٌ صَدَقُوا مَا عَاهَدُوا اللَّهَ عَلَيْهِ فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ قَضَى نَحْبَهُ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَنْتَظِرُ وَمَا بَدَّلُوا تَبْدِيلًا.
ليجزي الله الصادقين بصدقهم ويعذب الكافرين والمنافقين إن شاء وكان الله غفورا رحيما.
My brothers, the ayat of Quran Allah speaks for now, for us right now. It speaks the moment we're living in. My brothers and sisters, let's define where we're standing. Are we in the confederators' battle of 21st century, being from the hypocrite side, or being from those who صَدَقَ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ, to be from those who are honest with Allah and His Prophet. May Allah Azza wa Jal guide us to be able to stand for His deen. May Allah Azza wa Jal help us to be able to stand for those who have been treated injustice on earth, ya Rabbal Alameen. إِنَّ اللَّهُ مَلَائِكَتُهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك اللهم على وعلى المحبة فبركت على إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم أبنى عبيدك أبنى عبيدك أبنى إمائك نواصيل بيدك ماضي فينا حبك عبد فينا قضاءك. أسألك اللهم بكل اسم ولك سميت به نفسك أنزلته في كتابك أو علمته أحدا من خلقك أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك بأن تجعل القرآن العظيم ربيع قلوبنا يا الله. اللهم اجعل جلالنا منا وأحزاننا يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا ندعوك في هذا اليوم الفضيل وندعوك في هذه الساعة المباركة ندعوك وأنت الله الذي لا إله غيرك يا أحد يا فرد يا صمد يا من لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد يا حي يا قيوم يا من وسع كرسي السماوات والأرض ولا يؤوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم. نسألك بأنك أنت الله الذي لا إله غيرك بأن تنصر دينك يا رب العالمين. اللهم انصر دينك يا رب العالمين. اللهم أقر عيننا بنصر دينك يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا من جندك سخرنا لطاعتك استخدمنا لمرضاتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أنزل رحماتك على أهلنا في غزة. اللهم أنزل رحماتك على أهلنا في سوريا. اللهم أنزل رحماتك على أهلنا في العراق. اللهم أنزل رحماتك على أهلنا في ليبيا. اللهم أنزل رحماتك على أخواننا في بورما وفي كشمير وفي أفغانستان وفي الصومال وفي كل بقاع الأرض يا رب العالمين. اللهم أسألك بأنك أنت الله الذي لا إله غيرك بأن تقر عيننا لنصرينك يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارحم الأطفال يا الله. اللهم ارحم الشيوخ يا الله. اللهم احقن دماءنا واستر على أعراضنا. اللهم فك أسرانا يا ربي يا ربي إننا نبرأ إليك من حكامنا يا الله. يا ربي نسألك بأنك أنت الله الذي لا إله غيرك بأن توفقنا لنصرينك يا رب العالمين. اللهم نعوذ بجلالك أن نخل دينك يا الله. يا رب نعوذ بجلالك أن نخل دينك يا ربي. والله إنه لا حملنا ولا قوة إلا بك يا الله. يا رب إنا نتضرع إليك يا الله. حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. Oh Allah, we ask you for your mercy. You are the one who begets none, nor he must be gotten. And there is none who equal or comparable unto you, ya Allah. We pray to you and supplicate to you this day and this hour, ya Rabbil Alameen, to restore justice and peace on earth, ya Rabbil Alameen. Ya Allah, restore justice and peace on earth, ya Rabbil Alameen. Ya Allah, restore justice and peace on earth, ya Rabbil Alameen. Ya Allah, please arise in the liberty of your deen. Ya Allah, help us to be able to alleviate the suffering and aid those who are in difficulties, ya Rabbil Alameen. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.